Today, we're going to look at what's in a name. That's only part of the title. The second part of it is the names of God. Through his names, through the revelation of his names, he would reveal, or he still reveals, his character, his attributes, his power. In other words, whenever he speaks his name, he's saying, you know, this is who I am, and this is what I do, and this is what I'd like to do in your life, and this is what I'd like to change about you and in your life, and so on. We're just going to take a quick look at some of these names of God and how those names reveal God's character and God's nature. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Right? When you read that, in the beginning, God created. And the word that is used there to describe God is Elohim, which means it's in the plural, but it's referred to in the singular. But Elohim, which talks about the majesty of God, right? Which talks about the triune God. In the beginning, God created. And the word bara, which means he brought something out of nothing. And we read the creation account. We read through Genesis 1 and Genesis 2, and we see that God spoke things into existence. This awesome, this great, this amazing God, he spoke things into existence. Then we look at another name of God, which is El Shaddai, which means the Almighty. It also came to mean the bountiful, the all-sufficient one. So he visits Abraham when he's 99 years old, and he does a few things here. He introduces himself as the all-sufficient, as the bountiful one. He says, El Shaddai. I am El Shaddai, the all-sufficient, the bountiful one. And he does a few things. He says, I am this, I am so-and-so, I am El Shaddai. And he reminds them about his promise. This is what I promise, and this is what I will do in your life. If you diligently hear the voice of the Lord, your God, and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the God who heals you. Or in other words, he's saying, I'm Jehovah Rapha, I am the Lord, your health. So as we walk in fellowship with him, the Lord will speak to us. The Lord will, Lord will give us instruction how to steward our health and how to walk in divine health. Moses builds an altar and calls its name, the Lord is my banner, or the Lord is my banner of victory, Jehovah Nissi. Our God is Jehovah Nissi. And we're looking for spectacular things. The Lord will do spectacular things. But sometimes it's the everyday, it's the small things that he's asking us to do. Maybe some things that we are familiar with and we are comfortable with. And the Lord is saying, do those small things. Be consistent with those small things. And I want to give you victory. Right? I am Jehovah Nissi, your banner of victory. And then we see that the Lord is our provider, Jehovah Jireh. We are very familiar with this. The Lord is my provider. The Lord will provide because that's his name, and he has revealed himself in through his name, and that is his character, that is his attribute, that is his nature. And the heart of God, the Father heart of God, is that of a generous giver. And then we come to Jehovah Shalom. The Lord is peace. The Lord is introducing and saying, I'm Jehovah Shalom. I'm that anchor in that storm. In all that chaos, in all that confusion, I'm Jehovah Shalom. And in all that regret, in all that pain, I'm Jehovah Shalom. It'll cause you to move ahead, move forward, and fulfill the destiny. Then lastly, we come to Jehovah Rohi, the Lord my shepherd. Okay. Psalm 23 and verse 1, the psalmist declares, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He's testifying, saying, the Lord is my shepherd, the one who leads me, the one who cares for me, the one who nourishes me, the one who restores my battered emotions, the one who restores my soul. And he makes a very important declaration, and he's saying, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life because I follow the shepherd who is good. And the word follow, it means chase and hunt. That's his declaration. Surely goodness, and I'm not going to chase after goodness and mercy, but goodness and mercy will come chasing after me because I follow the good shepherd. And the thing is this, the names of God are His revelation. And His revelation is not just information for us, but it's an invitation for each one of us. You know, that's the important thing, that maybe for us it has been information, you know, but we need to see, we need to know that it is an invitation for us to experience, to encounter this God.